Hey guys, welcome to our stream. We're happy to be here tonight with Banjo Kazooie.
A brand new game.
Well, not a new game, but a new game to play for us. Yes. This game is something that I got when I was a kid, but because Ocarina of Time came out at the same time, more or less, I think I spent most of my time playing. This is something that Smith has played a little bit more.
It was one of my favorite games when I was a kid. I loved it. I don't think we ever beat it, though. We played and played and played and played, and my dad would even play sometimes, like, to try to help
us
get stuff, like, through different parts that we were stuck on.
Right on.
And I don't know if we ever made it all the way through, but I'm excited to beat it this time, so.
Yeah, well, we're excited to be here with you guys tonight, and we're going to go ahead and get started. This is our second game that we've been playing on Twitch. Our first game was Mother 3, and we finished that just a couple nights ago.
Much to our own sadness, it had quite the ending. But it was fun. We had a good time. We had a really good time.
Well, we're grateful that you guys are with us. And want to thank WhiteGuy34 for giving us a follow.
Yeah, right as we were starting, we had that little notification come through. And so, thank you. That really means a lot to us to see that you've... take an interest in our little project here.
Alright, let's go ahead and get started.
Lots of sounds all at once. I remember just like hating this little N walking around.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. Well, it was just always like anytime you turn your Nintendo on, you'd have to watch this dumb little animation over and over and over again. I just wanted to play my game. But it gets right into it pretty quick here.
Always loved it.
Did you? Yeah. It's funny, like, it's clever. I just wanted to get playing Banjo-Kazooie. I was, like, 8 years old or 7 years old. When did this game come out? Was it 1998, so I would have been, like, 8 or 9 years old, I guess, then. And this is a good game.
Isn't that Banjo's sister?
I have no idea. That guy's Mumbo, right?
Yeah, I think that's Mumbo.
That is Nintendo xylophone. I think that is Banjo's sister. She doesn't really, as far as I remember, play much of a role in the game, though. She's just kind of here at the beginning of things. It's just really Banjo and Kazooie.
Guess we'll find out.
I guess so. Because we're playing a game that's designed for the 4:3 layer box format, we are broadcasting widescreen. We've done a little bit of a blur on the edge to stretch the screen and fill the space, but if for some reason we get feedback from you guys that you don't like that, we have some other options available to us as well. So we thought we'd give it a try for tonight.
Yeah, we've got a couple of things that we can do. We decided to put this blur right up here, just to make it work.
It's kind of stretches
but
it.
We could just stretch the entire screen, or we could like a scaling background or a scrolling background in the background. I don't know. Yeah.
Oh, the witch. What's her name?
Gruntilda
or something like that. She, like, speaks in fart noises.
She?
And burps. Listen to her. She's gonna talk. I'm pretty sure. I don't know. Maybe I don't remember.
This game got re-released on the Xbox 360.
Here she is. Oh, no. She's not. It's somebody else in the game that does that. She's picking her nose.
Him the Jay?
What?
Thank you so much for the donation.
Love the stream so far. I enjoy those games that I never got to play. Keep it up. Thank you. That's really, really awesome of you. We appreciate that.
Wow, you're great. Thanks a lot.
I think that makes I Am the Jay our top donator so far, right?
Yeah, top donor. I'm sure that
top
will...
donator. Top donor is the right word for it.
Yeah, there it is right here.
Yeah, fantastic.
Cool, thanks a lot.
Thank you, that's awesome. No, 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 you must be mad. Nicer beauty can't be had. Is she talking rhyme all the time?
I think so.
Fortunately, I think you'll find it's Tootie. She's cutie. What a funny little villain. I remember being like so amazed at these yellow flowers and being able to wander around in them. This was back when, at least for me, like these 3D worlds were just kind of a new thing. We had Super Mario 64,
mm-hmm.
That came out really quite a while before this, didn't it?
Yeah, it came out a couple years before.
I don't know. We had very few Nintendo 64 games when we first started out. We had Super Mario 64 that I think came with our console.
Mm-hmm.
And my parents, I remember, bought us Donkey Kong or Diddy Kong Racing. And we played the heck out of that game too. And then I think this was our third N64 game. And for a while, like, it was, we had those three and those were the ones that we'd play. We would rent ones that we wanted to do, like, at the video store on the weekend, because everyone would go and rent videos. And so I think I played Tony Hawk Pro Skater and GoldenEye and a few of those that way. But this game, this was one that we played a lot, played through quite a bit.
Yeah, we had the game, but I don't think we played it very much.
I loved this game. I still do.
I think we're missing part of the story here.
Yeah.
I don't know how much story there is. There's a witch that's flying around.
It's out to get us. Come get me, my little pretty. You'll soon be ugly. What a pity. So she kidnaps the sister. Maybe that's why.
Yeah,
let me go, you ugly old hag. That's why I don't remember her in the game much. It's because I think we're after, like, getting her back.
Huh. Looks like we got a couple people in the chat as well. White guy says, good luck, guys. I haven't played this game since I was a kid, but I remember it being difficult.
It was so hard. I remember, like, just, like, you get into some of the later levels, and we would play for hours at a time trying to get through different little conquests or courses that we were supposed to do, and... It's a tough one.
Now we're adults, we'll see how long it takes us to get through it.
I'm probably still just as bad. I am the J says he prefers the name Donator over Donor, so...
Interesting.
We'll call you our top Donator then.
Yeah, this is the very first Banjo game.
This is, yeah.
There was Banjo Kazooie as well. And then...
That one was also for the N64, right? Kazooie. I don't think I ever played Banjo Kazooie at all. I recently learned that was even a game. Needless Exposition says she's going to be finishing Mother 1 tomorrow.
Oh, right on.
I lost my no game over streak.
Shoot.
Darn it.
That's the worst.
Let's get to Banjo and his crazy bird brain friend Kazooie. Yeah, Tootie was for the N64. They've apparently re-released this game for some of the newer consoles. The Xbox 360, is that what you found out?
I think also on the Xbox One with
Xbox
the
One.
Rare Replay, where they put a bunch of those games together.
Because they bought all of them, didn't they?
Yeah, Microsoft bought
Rare. Purchased the entire Rare collection. Well, it's cool that they're still around. Like, I don't know that I've seen any of the video from the newest games, but or the newest re-releases of the games, but I imagine that they've done some upscaling and things that way. Redone the texture packs or something.
Hey, the Bach28, thanks for giving us a follow.
The Bach28.
Welcome to the stream.
You're now a piece in our puzzle.
Yes.
I don't know, in our last game, Mother, for those of you who have played, they frequently, when like a new person attaches themselves as one of the playable characters, there's always the phrase, so-and-so has joined the party. But we've used that so far, we'll have to come up with something new for followers during this game.
Although I think that sound plays quite often.
We'll be hearing it quite a bit. That is the truth. You have to do there's the double jump where the bird carries you a little bit too, isn't there?
Yeah, there's the Z and A, which does like a big jump.
They like relearn the
honeycomb piece, click six of us. Piece.
To relearn all of our game mechanics here because we've
haven't played this game
for a long time, years. So I think at this point we're just kind of like try attacking that carrot. I think we're just trying to kind of learn, get a feel for.
It's kind of an open area to
how all of that happens. Yeah.
Those little molehills will also teach you some moves. I think it's just basically jump and attack, or A and B buttons.
Ooh. Oh.
You can do some double jumps and things that would clearly just fail that.
There's one of them, I remember you did the double jump and then the bird like flaps or soars or something to the next one.
I wonder if I have to learn those moves.
Maybe you do, maybe they're not unlocked, like right out of the gate.
I don't know.
Is this like Super Mario where your oxygen refills your health?
I think they may be separate.
They appear to be. Is all that came before the honeycombs for the water there.
Okay, I do have that.
How does it work?
I was just pushing it too late, I think. Here we are.
Oh, there we are. Thank goodness Kazooie's a strong little bird.
Got a one-up.
Look out for me.
I'm an extra life.
Extra life. Cool. We'll probably be needing those.
Hey, Brozel, welcome to our stream. Good to have you here. We are playing this game, Banjo Kazooie. It's my first time through it. I think Smith right here has played quite a bit of it, but we haven't.
I don't think either of us have beaten it. Like, I don't remember this game ever ending for me as a child.
This goes on forever.
We just kept trying and trying. We got to the portion in the later level where we meet Clank, and I remember we were just like, oh, we can't get past this. We probably also got some new, like either a new console or some cool new game that took us away from Banjo time.
Who's Clank? Is he another character?
He's a character that we'll see later in the game, but he's like this giant underwater food disposal or something like that. Looks like a big fish. He's just pretty disgusting. But we don't meet him for quite a while, I don't think. For a few hours, anyway. There we go. Underwater swimming in this game was always really hard to do. Which is why that level was so hard. I remember you had to go down and swim through. There's like a keyhole or something.
Oh, yeah?
You had to get through it a couple of times to, like, crank his leash. And I don't remember what happened exactly. Or open a door. Open a drain. I don't remember. But it was just super hard. You'd run out of oxygen, and then you'd die, and you'd have to start over again.
One thing about coming back to play these old games is sometimes they don't age as well. Like, the controls are hard. It's a little different. The controls seem pretty good.
I remember really liking the controls on this game.
I used to like the controls for GoldenEye, too.
That's true. Well, did you play the new Wii U? Or not the Wii U, but the regular Wii release of GoldenEye? Where you had to have like you had to like aim with one, and you had your little nunchuck in the other hand. It was horrible. I don't know how that ever made it through.
New games don't all get it right either.
I don't know how that ever made it through testing. GoldenEye was definitely a little hard to.
I think that's probably one play mechanic, because I remember you could play it with like controller.
Uh huh.
Probably just their gimmicky Wiimote.
Sure it is. So, they're just trying to use.
Not all games
technology.
Have good control. And spoiled by some really great.
This game, though, I think has some pretty good ones. MJ says, it's so hard because the flipping bird is there trying to be a swimmer. Come on, guys. Birds are terrible swimmers. True, they go down and they get their... I don't know, ducks do that. They swim underwater with their wings. They find worms or whatever's in the water that they eat. Well, thanks for the honeycomb, Onion.
Let's see.
But you're right. If it was just the bear swimming for himself... probably be a little more adept. No. The honeycomb.
There's five of them. I'm assuming there's another one somewhere.
Are we supposed to start with just a full palette of them, I guess?
Well, I think when you collect them...
We're going for completeness here. There's something flying up there that's giving a shadow. What is that?
I think it's like
is that a cauliflower?
Looks like an onion or something. I don't know.
It's a flying onion. I wonder if we can get to it. It looks like a cauliflower. Or something. Come on, come up this way to get it to follow you until it's...
It's trying to attack.
It's gonna kill us. It's not worth its...
Yeah, it just
not worth
took
its
two
time.
And gave you one.
All right, let's try... Can we advance into the game now?
We haven't gone up here.
To the top of the map. Everything was very angular in these days.
For sure.
They had, like, hexagonal mounds of dirt.
I remember always being excited for when games could actually produce circles well.
Uh-huh.
There's the way, Bottle Boy.
Cross the bridge to enter Gruntilda's lair. Look out for me inside. Good luck. That text seems like it scrolls pretty slow.
Hey, Hosis, welcome to our stream. It's good to have you here, too.
Oh, Grintilda.
Kind of laser beam and contraption will make me young and too old.
There
you go,
contraption.
You old hag. Brother will come and kick your butt. Rescue you, he will not dare. There's many Hey, Klungo, push the switch. I'm tired of being an ugly witch.
Bleep.
Yes, Mistress Grunty.
Yes, Mistress Grunty. Power is ready. Oh.
Can't I just go kick that witch's butt?
Poor little sister. No, we have to fight through all her minions first. And tricks and traps.
Let's see who wins.
See.
Hey, it's me, Mr. Jiggy. Now go and find a picture with a...
One of the things that I remember really liking about this game was that when, they have those puzzle pieces that you enter into the paintings, but you could stay in there and explore even after you'd completed levels.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it just has a little bit more of an open, undirected feel. It's obviously a very directed game, but... This one, for example, here, we're going to fill in that piece.
To the world...
Must fill in the missing spaces with jigsaw pieces. So with this one, we're only missing one of them.
Oh, I imagine that we're going to have to find lots of pieces.
We're going to have to find a whole bunch of them throughout this game.
Oh, goodness. I don't think we're going for 100%, but...
Yeah, we'll see, I guess, how that all works out for us. All right. That's it. The picture's complete. The door to Mumbo's Mountain is open. It was such an easy fit. The other is just to wit. You just test to wit.
So, this is...
Cool.
Welcome, Hockey Lover 1017.
Block 28's back.
We are just starting this.
Yeah, we literally are beginning tonight, so you've tuned in at the right time.
There are three moves I've got to learn in this level.
Help! Backflip, there you go.
Save me.
Grintilda has imprisoned five of us, Jinjos. Jinjos?
Each world free us to get a Jiggy.
Alrighty.
We're Jiggy, so funny.
Free us to get a Jiggy. Would you like a Jiggy? The sound effects are pretty darn goofy. This whole game just has a really unique feel to it.
Yeah.
Everything about it, like the animations and all. He's just super, I don't know, it's probably why we loved it as kids. Super bright and vivid.
The music reminds me of like Splash Mountain. Bit,
yeah,
like
it kind of does.
Disneyland.
It kind of does. I can see that.
There are 100 of these notes on each level.
Think Spaghetti says, "Hello, gentlemen."
Hello.
Hello, hello. Welcome to the chat.
Welcome to the stream.
And the stream. Now, collecting music notes. They're kind of like gold coins in Mario.
Yeah, there's 100 in each level.
Okay.
That's kind of like
so if we're
coins.
Going for completeness, we gotta catch them all.
I don't know. Like, if you miss one, then...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Not very good at these controls yet.
I think that it was probably this game that has, like, given me so much anxiety about being able to, like, walk along little bridges and things like this in video games.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because it's just so hard to, like, keep the character walking straight here. Some free honeycomb if we ever need any. I don't know if those stay there if we leave them alone or not, but we'll certainly give them a chance. These are the nastiest. I hate them. Like all their little legs fall off and their eyeball rolls out. We're giant ants and we come apart.
That's probably the nastiest that this game gets. It's not like
Conker's
Bad Fur Day.
Well, no, they, like, when you get down to the Clank levels and stuff, you're like in the sewer.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you've got some of that same, like, it doesn't surprise me that the same studio produced Conker's Bad Fur Day.
It'd be a fun game to play on stream, too.
It'd be a vulgar game.
I only played, like, the first half of it. It'd be a little bit vulgar.
Yeah. We typically try to have a pretty clean stream, so... Missing out on musical notes.
What hey, you found? A jiggy.
It's a jiggy. You say?
You must search for...
All of us on each world will help you progress through the witch's lair. Oh, same sound twice in a row.
Xenonix,
I think. Yeah, thanks for the follow.
Welcome to the stream, too.
Welcome to the stream. Is that Mumble that's up there? We gotta carry those eggs, don't we?
I think we pick them up. Another completion.
Oh, he can fire him. No, he can fire him. He can shoot him, I think. What's up, mole friend? Doggle?
Talontrot will let Chewie tackle steep slopes with ease. Should do it. Hold Z, then press the left C button.
Hold Z while moving Kazooie around with the control stick. Go practice. Well, that big slope is probably for there. I'd forgotten about that.
So some slopes are, Banjo isn't able to scale.
His paws are just too slippery.
I don't see why the bird just doesn't fly.
Alright. Well, probably because she's having to carry a whole bear around with her everywhere she does. What's up, Jinjo? Jinjo!
Xenonix says, this is easily one of my faves. Gonna enjoy watching. Oh, well, we appreciate having you here.
I'm glad. It's one of my favorites, too. Even, like... I've never finished it. I say in shame. Now, when I was a kid, this was like Friday nights. I remember being like locked down in my basement just for hours playing this game. We were really terrible at it. My dad used to have to step in and try to help us sometimes. But those are some of my favorite memories of my dad too. So I had to spend time playing Banjo Kazooie together.
That's cool. My dad wouldn't play very many video games with that. He definitely.
Don't.
Would like sing the or whistle them
and get the song stuck in their head.
Yeah, like the Mario Beat theme.
Press Z to send Kazooie slamming hard to the ground. We've already done that move, haven't we?
Yeah.
I don't like the sound of that banjo.
Used to it, Nest Girl. We'll be using it a lot.
Right. Spaghetti says we all have to carry bears at some point in life. We've all got our own bears to bear. Excited to see the whole story too. I've never finished it either.
Cool.
My dad hated that I played video games. I just don't tell him that I'm a grown man that still plays and we get along better.
I told my dad that we're streaming online and
he was excited for us.
He's kind of like he's a photographer and so he wanted to help us out, like make sure we got the green screen right.
The lighting and all of that.
Yeah, you had like tips for us and yeah. So he was helping us out a little bit.
Yeah, he was excited for us. Hashtag bears to bear. I'm glad we've got someone who can make some hashtags for us in this stream. In our last stream, we had a couple of people that were doing that for us. We started a Twitter account. You can see it down there in the bottom left corner. And we put your hashtags to good use, for sure.
Make some images of...
Bears to bear.
Bears to bear.
Hashtag bears to bear. Hashtag bear arms. Bear arms. Bear feet.
Did Kazooie just eat that that jiggy?
That's what Kazooie does with lots of things. Look, there's a silver skull. Eat gumble gumble.
Me Mumbo's token. Use for Mumbo's magic. Okay, that means.
Xenonix asks, what if you are the bear?
There you are.
you're the bear to bear. Maybe you're a bear bearing bears. All the way to the top of Mumbo's skull. Ikampokam. He's asleep.
Mumbo? You Mumbo. Best shaman in all game. Help Banjo and Filthy Feather.
Watch it, boy.
Those magic tokens. Hit by witch.
Move my head.
And just not got enough tokens for Mumbo magic. Look at sign. Bring more.
We need 5 magic tokens.
And he'll do some
I remember
magic.
Being able to get up into the rafters, like in this little hut of his. Look up. Can we control the camera at all? We'd be able to get up there. There's eggs. That's what it was. Wondered if there was another silver skull.
How do you get up there?
You have to jump onto the flames, I think.
There we are.
Find a little pole to stand on.
Alright.
I loved collecting all these little things when I was a kid. No.
Kinda just drive me a little crazy now. Just another thing to have to get.
Mm-hmm, yep.
We Juju Mumbo's totem pole. Beat us with nice blue stones.
Ah, that's where we have to shoot those.
Yeah, I just have the ability to shoot them.
To barf them up in a straight line.
They come over here.
Xenonix says the stuff up there on the top of that shelf changes per level.
Oh, really?
Huh.
We have to learn one more attack. I think it might be over here.
I think Spaghetti loves the talking in this game. There, and I haven't seen it personally, but a friend was telling me that we need to watch a YouTube video that talks about like some of the voice actors and like their stories about making this game. Because they like spent time in studio recording all of these weird little sounds that you're hearing. And apparently some of them have some kind of funny stories that go with them. Don't touch Konga's blocks. MJ asks, what if he is the bear? B-A-R-E. Whoa. You're a clever bear, find Konga's gold. I guess that didn't hurt us. Alright, Konga, come down off your tree.
Hey, that Konga's orange.
Yum, oranges are nice. Oh, Chimpy like Konga orange. Chimpy help. Fat bear and bird. We're like right in front of some of the letters this time. Again.
Let's see if we can figure that out. Change this to be. We're gonna be a little bit smaller.
We'll get small down here in the corner.
Okay, we're a little bit smaller.
We'll be able to read a little easier that way. Perfect. Tiny-S, is that how you say your username? Tiny-S? Thanks for the follow.
Good to have you here.
Maybe it's Tinius.
Tinius?
Tinius. 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 We've got so many eggs. Or blue stones, if that's what they're calling
them. Blue stones, yeah.
What's up, Goggles? Time for Buzzard to learn the ancient ways. The egg. Oh, here we go. I'm listening, Beetle Breath. I love how much they hate each other. Hold Z, then press the C button to shoot an egg out of your mouth.
Sounds cool.
Anything else?
Press the bottom C button instead, and you can shoot them from behind.
Sheesh, sounds painful. Wish I'd never asked.
Oh, great.
Birdbrain can carry 100 eggs in her backpack. Oh, and you can also use control stick. Use the control stick to aim while you're crouching. Exciting, huh? Badoomch. Oh, I guess there is a pun intended there. use eggs. Here's 50 to practice with. That's nice.
Sweet. Cool.
Can you imagine having the script for this? It has to have been quite the project to embark on.
I think it would have been fun working on this game.
I think so too. Rare was really kind of like the center of all of the cool games during that time period. They were doing just about everything that was popular. And they did a good job at it too. Like,
I played Donkey Kong Country so
much. Oh my gosh. They really made some great games. They had this review process that they'd go through where they'd call it the 48 hours of hell, from what I have heard. And they would they'd send in their games, like their when they were working on them in the build process, and they would have a little focus group at Nintendo test them, and they would play for 48 hours straight. Anytime that they'd run into any sort of a glitch in the game or something that just wasn't working properly, they would send the demo that had been sent back to Rare, and then when the problem was resolved, they would have to start the 48 hours of hell over again.
That sounds so awful.
Just the time after time, like, I don't know how it would be to have one of those testing jobs. Can you imagine being like stuck with a game that like was like not fully developed for that long?
I have had friends that have worked in like QA.
Yeah, that's like basically what this is. I think is
quality assurance. And it just sounds miserable. Like, you don't enjoy the game at all because it's not finished, it's not polished.
It's just all about working out the bugs and the kinks, right?
Yeah.
It does seem like it'd be a little bit miserable for sure. But who knows?
Price. You give price to.
Aw, thank you, Bear. I. Congo. Poor things, all like dejected up there now.
Donkey Kong Country 1 through 3 were amazing.
I was never a Donkey Kong guy. I loved Diddy Kong Racing.
Well, you're not super into platform.
Yeah, I'm not.
But maybe Donkey Kong would be a good intro.
Perhaps.
That would be a fun game to play next to. Oh my gosh, I would love that.
There's a million good games out there.
How do I shoot? Welcome to our stream.
You've arrived just at the time when we learned to shoot eggs. It was some good timing there. How do I shoot eggs?
Out of my bum.
Out of my bum or my beak.
What's that little voice?
1, 2, 3, 4. I think they're the ants inside of the anthill. Oh, really? There, yeah. There's ants in here. The ugly no bears allowed in the Tickers Tower. Sorry, we just destroyed your entire everything. All their legs pop off. Their head and their eyes roll. Hey, look.
It's too steep.
That's what we need. We gotta get his little bird feet going.
Well, we need to do. How do we get that going?
It was C and Z, right?
Z and then C left.
Oh, they're termites. They're not ants. They're termites.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. Even, that's what Xena likes to say.
Kind of glad they explode.
This is just really tricky. What's up there? Let's take a look at the camera.
Yeah, I guess I can.
Let's take a peek and see if it's something that we want. Something to lure us to the top. There's a million eggs up there. There's also some music notes. What's on the shelves? Anything?
Looks like
we're probably gonna have to go up there to get some of those silver skulls totems.
I don't know if I can get up there with state.
Yeah, it doesn't
seem these platforms are
too steep.
Too steep.
Doesn't seem like we're gonna be able to. I don't know.
Sneaky
guess we'll find
Pole,
out.
Welcome to our stream.
Sneaky Pole. Well, how many do we have? Is there a way for us to see? We've collected 3 of those so far, and we need
the
5,
skulls?
Right? Yeah.
We have.
But that's pretty.
Move down this way. We've got 3.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, the emulator we're using on the Mac doesn't display everything super great.
It's having some rendering trouble right here, it looks like.
Yeah, on the flat screen. It doesn't. This is okay for the rest of it.
Wonder what would cause that. That's strange.
But I'm just glad it works.
Yeah. Wonder if it's like a certain file type that's in use in the game or something.
Oh, that texture is
like a static image or something. We've already explored all the way up and around there.
We explored everything here?
We got that little Jinjo or whatever they're called from the top. Let's see if we can get up to the top of the anthill. Oh, you know what? I remember how we get up into onto those really slanty ones.
Oh.
Mumbo helps us. He has to curse us, I think. By shooting your eggs in the mouth of that.
Well, now that I can, I'll do that.
Oops.
Guess I have to time.
Yeah, it's all about timing here. Here we are.
Oh. Make sure I get that.
That's really... really a tricky thing to jump on top of. He seems like he's spinning way faster than before. All right, last one.
Happens. Oh, sweet. We got an extra life.
Because it was one of the hollow ones, right?
Yeah. You get collect six of those hollow ones, you get an extra
life. Shasta TM has just joined the chat.
Welcome back to the stream, Shasta.
Says the music for this game is so good. I take it, Xenonix, that Grant Kirkhope is the composer. He says Grant Kirkhope is a genius.
Yeah, I think I saw that when I was preparing all the assets for the stream. I was trying to find the music for when we got donors and
oh my gosh, this is really challenging. You got it. Puzzle piece. Jiggy, I guess. We have to use that strange word that they're using in the game. We got a jiggy.
Got a jiggy.
Kazooie is shooting what appear to be like blue robin eggs or something.
Yeah, that's what they look like. They were like blue stones is what they described them as. That's... So how do we get up to the top of that?
So we're going to have to wait. We need to collect our 5 skulls, and I think that Mumbo curses us and turns us into like an ant.
Oh, really? Like a termite?
Yeah, or a termite, whatever they are. If I remember right, I think that's what happens. Judas Mac says, get jiggy with it. Get jiggy. Oh yeah, get jiggy with it. Not with it, but with it. For babies.
Look,
there's another Jinjo.
Jinjo?
Jinjo.
Maybe I should.
Listen to their little voices when they,
They talk, don't they?
They do. Listen. Jinjo! I noticed that the last time. They just have a funny little audio bite there. '64 games are a completionist's dream, or maybe nightmare.
My nightmare, for sure. I think it was just spawned because of Mario 64 was just a complete completionist game.
Yep.
And everybody was like, me too.
With this game, so there's a website called howlongtobeat.com. It basically just data gathers how long people are taking to do the different things that they're doing in games. And so there's like a few different statistics that they offer. There's one of them that shows just like a regular playthrough and how many hours it would take you. There's also one that's like for a completionist, and I'm trying to remember what that third category was called. I don't remember exactly. With this game, I think the completionist version of it was somewhere like 20 hours or something. It like added another 5 or 6 hours onto the game time. There are a lot of different little side projects to work on, which makes it fun. I think it's cool to be able to run through and collect music notes or whatever you happen to be doing. When I was a kid, I hated that kind of stuff. No, we have to go to Mumbo, remember? We need our 5 skulls.
We have 3 of them. I don't know where.
Do we not get the rest in this level? Look up in the trees. Can we go up into the top of those trees?
There's some stuff up here.
Yeah, there's a puzzle piece, too. And we walk up the hill. Xenonix says that it seems excessive doing the completionist.
Yeah.
The completionist go at the game.
A little crazy.
Yeah, it really is.
I've got 88 of these guys.
Yeah, we're getting close to the 100, aren't we?
Although I think that there were some in that termite that
we're just not gonna be able to get quite yet. That's true. We have to become a termite, I'm sure. Unless those are just for later. It could be that they're for later. We're missing six of them now, and there may have been exactly that many up there. 20 hours, he says, seems excessive. He is a completionist, so 20 hours is probably over the top. I'm probably remembering that number wrong.
I bet you there are six inside that termite.
Completionist time for Skyrim is 210 hours.
Holy cow.
That's some dedication.
Should we go for 100% on our next game?
Holy cow.
Skyrim?
That's like several months of like full-time work. That's crazy.
It's true. It's really crazy. Yeah, we don't have enough.
But I guess not several months. It's like a month and a half of full-time work. Come on, skulls.
I think we've collected everything we can get so far.
We have. Take a look and see what's on top of that ant hill, or the termite hill.
So there's like a jiggy up there.
Yeah, there is. We can see it flashing.
Like a shiny jiggy.
Well, I think it's just not rendering fully because it's in the distance.
Oh, yeah,
I think
probably.
That's just the sparkle effect. JDS Mac completed all but 5 hours of the 210 for Skyrim.
Holy cow. That's crazy.
That is some serious dedication to a game.
Or he didn't do even 5 hours.
Vinonic says you can get everything without leaving the level.
Oh, here's another one.
Alright.
So there's one more that we need, so here it is.
Oh, I had that backward. JDS Mac only played 5 hours. Not 205 hours, but 5.
Yeah, I didn't play 5 hours.
I agree, Tanias. The transformations in this game are awesome. Swing around underwater. Even the music goes to an underwater sound.
Uh-huh. Cool.
I love it. Yeah, just without even, like, missing a beat. Oof.
It's
like instant death. Can we fire eggs at him?
Okay.
He's not gonna love that.
I can shoot him like crazy.
Go and pound him while he's down.
Oh yeah.
Oh, now too late. I think you have to subdue him like that and then pound him.
Doesn't like it. It's like not letting me.
It won't. Maybe you're not allowed to kill that character. You can just knock him down. Yeah, it won't let you jump on top of him, and he's got like,
I'll try it again.
He's got like a no-fly zone above him. We're almost out of eggs. Try grabbing his tail. Can you do that?
I'm gonna try to.
Nothing. Nope. Nothing at all. We're almost dead.
Die.
You gotta get out of here.
Where's that other? I thought that maybe he might have that other silver skull.
Okamio7 asks, is this a completely blind playthrough, or just been playing a long time sort of blind? Good question.
I played this game for a couple hours when I was a kid, and Smith here.
I played it quite a bit when I was a kid, but I never beat it. So it's not necessarily like blind. But I wouldn't say that it's fresh enough in my memory to be considered something where, like, I know exactly where we're going and what we're doing either. It'll be a lot of, like, oh, I remember this along the way. Like, a lot of those moments. But as far as, if we know right where to go and what to do, definitely not. We're gonna be kind of, feeling our way through and playing by discovery, I think. Think Spaghetti says, Until Dawn is a 7-hour game, according to the How Long to Beat.
Oh, really?
Maybe my next game. So that particular game, interestingly enough, I don't know how much you've like read about it, but it is one that's designed to be played over and over again. It actually, I don't know if any of you ever did the like choose your own adventure stories when you were a kid. The ones where you like, okay, like we've decided this, go to page 7 now and continue, or that kind of thing.
I loved those when I was a kid.
They're really, really cool.
I had a Mario one that I loved.
Yep. We would get them from like the library, I remember. We would check them out there. But the Until Dawn is kind of like that. It's designed to like dramatically change the game when you make certain choices. There's obviously like a main plot line to it, but it is a 7-hour game that you can play over and over again and have it be, you know, pretty different almost every time that you play it, with exception of like the main skeleton of the story, I guess. Kind of a cool one. I'm excited to play it myself.
played a game called Fahrenheit with Shasta when we were, I don't know, it was probably about 8 years ago.
Blub-blub.
Thanks for following us.
Is that right? Blub-blub. Blub-blub? Bob Loblaw's Loblog.
Yeah, there you are.
Bob Loblaw's Loblog. Thanks for the follow.
Welcome back to our stream.
Yeah, Traden's here.
Oh no, that killed me. Shoot.
Traden says, what? Why didn't I get a notification about this? Sorry, I don't know what happened.
Oh no.
Smash Bros. Font, Traden lightens up the party.
Great.
Jesta says he's not getting updates about us either. I think that you have to set that up in your settings. I'm not sure, like, where in the account settings that is, but within Twitch itself, it'll give you the option to receive notifications.
Yeah.
About, like, certain streams, anyway.
I don't think we have anything collected anymore.
Blubblub says that's right. Perfect pronunciation. If I'm saying it now the correct way, I think I said it about four different ways. Blubblub or Blubblub?
Oh no, it's making us start over again.
Oh, are you serious?
Okay, move your head
okay.
to the side a little bit.
No,
okay,
we still have
so
four.
We still have those four guys.
Boy, that screen really doesn't want to render properly. There's something to be said for playing these games on the actual consoles that they were designed for.
Yeah, we just don't have a capture card.
We just don't have the capture.
We have a capture card, we can play some legit N64 games for the consoles. I feel like we need to kill that guy. There's got to be a way to do it.
Who here's played this recently enough that can tell us if there's, like, some way to actually get rid of him?
Because I swear that's going to be where the other...
The other crystal skull is or something. We've only got so many of those that we can use. Stay away from those horns. Look sharp. Esta says his follow thing is on, just under the window. Not sure why it doesn't broadcast that we're on. I don't know, maybe there's something that we need to look into on our settings that just isn't done quite right. We'll have to take a peek after the broadcast tonight. GDS Max says, I thought you needed the bowl to charge into something. Or maybe we have to lure him into some other area over there?
Or maybe we have to charge it to him. There's still one more attack we haven't tried.
Jordan says that we should get the N6040 USB adapter. He's got an Android that served him loyally through the years. Wonderful purchase. Right. N6040 USB adapter, does that allow you to connect like the actual N64 console to your computer?
Yeah. Or
what
at
is
least
that?
The controller.
Oh, for the controller. Okay. Yeah. I see that. I see what you're saying. I love the N64 controller. A lot of people will argue that the GameCube had the best controller ever made, but in my book, it's still the N64.
You haven't played enough Smash.
Yeah, I kind of hate playing Smash with the GameCube controller. I would prefer to play it with, like, that classic controller that comes with the Wii, or that you can buy for the Wii.
Yeah?
Yeah, I find that easier.
You mean like a controller like this one?
Not like that one, but the one, the little round one that you can attach to the Wiimote. You know the one I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I don't know. Pink Spaghetti says, why did you introduce me to How Long to Beat?
Isn't it great?
Isn't it a great
website? I looked up
website?
Like a ton of different games.
It's funny because I was talking, it was a friend at work this week that told me that he's using that. He says, I hate being an adult. I have to get on and decide if I actually have like enough
hey,
time.
Trayden, thanks so much for the donation.
Getting jiggy with it. Cue sarcastic laughter and the entire room groaning. Thank you for the donation. That's awesome.
You're the man. Thanks a lot. Sorry I cut you off.
Oh, that's okay. So anyway, he was just saying that he hates having to like try to budget his time out to play games. Like it used to be that he'd just play whatever he wanted and who cares how long it took, but
yeah, weren't those the days?
Yeah, he says now a lot of his gaming decisions are contingent on whether or not he'll actually be able to play through. So it's a cool little tool to use. Apparently the Harvest Moon completionist time is over 2,004 hours.
Holy cow.
That is
a bit of Harvest Moon.
That's like a year-long project.
That's
just
crazy.
Or maybe more than that even. That's got some serious dedication involved.
You open a world door, baddies escape and roam around.
Resta says maybe you need to play Twitch. How long is Completionist on Twitch, Shasta? Xenonix says that the bull is just an invincible enemy, one that we can't kill. I agree, thanks, Spaghetti. The N64 was really good. The only complaint that I have with that controller was that the analog stick wasn't super hot.
It would wear out.
It was not designed to be played as long as most people needed to play.
Well, there were games like Mario Party that where you have to
grind
the controller like this.
Rip a hole in your hand.
Yeah, your palm would be like bright red after those party games. And your controller would be loose after that, and it wouldn't work as well.
That's funny. That's exactly what the Bach 28 is saying.
Oh, really?
The N64 controller scarred his palm.
Oh my gosh, so rough.
That unfortunately is a common thing, I think.
Yeah, that thing. Like, I think that Nintendo issued like gloves.
Yeah.
So if you went into Nintendo.com, you could sign up for some gloves because they realized that so many people were getting like these really rough sores in the middle of their hands
from
the way the games were designed. So
and it would wear your controller out and your hand. You couldn't play even if you got a new one.
I think that's the reason why Mario Party 1 never came out like on the Wii U, but Mario Party 2 and Mario Party 3 did, because they limited those mini games afterward.
Yep.
Subsequent releases, but
I am the J says the N64 controller felt like the future. It was just like, I don't know, the ergonomics of it. It just fits so perfectly in your hand. Maybe that was just because we were kids, but who knows. Fasta likes the Xbox Mini controller.
Yeah, that's a good controller too.
Yeah, that one's one that I've heard good things about. I don't know if I've really used it personally, but
you mean like the
small
Xbox 360 one?
Yeah.
The original Xbox had a controller that was like this big. It was huge. And so I think we've got some of those.
Oh, are they the ones that you're talking about?
Yeah.
I was thinking of a smaller one that I believe is designed to work with like iPads and things. We may have to look into getting one of those little adapters that Traden's talking about. That'd be kind of fun.
We'll have to see if I still have any controllers at my parents' house.
I know my parents do for sure.
I remember we gave some of those controllers to your sister for Christmas.
Oh, that's right, because she wanted an N64 and some games, huh?
Sure. Did we give her our copy of Banjo Kazooie too?
I think my parents have one still for sure.
I'm down here.
The completionist time for Guild Wars is only 2 hours, or what is it? Are you asking? Oh, he's asking what's the completionist time for Guild Wars 2?
This is like the Night Witch.
Yeah, it's Gruntilda's
sister,
I don't know.
To avoid a fiery fate. Press B if you'd like to hear that.
Sure. Grunty's plan is rather cunning. When I'm thinking, guys, guys will come running.
Her whole goal of this game is like to become
to look
thin
beautiful.
And beautiful.
She needs an extreme makeover. You should set up one of those GoFundMes or something.
There you go.
Instead of kidnapping young little girls and building evil science machines. Deep Trout loves the original Xbox controller.
A really big
good
fat
for
one?
Good for big hands, he says.
I guess so.
A really big fat one.
Yeah.
That controller was huge. It was a good controller though. I remember really liking it as well.
I never
I never had an Xbox myself. I was always playing on friends' Xboxes. I would have like Halo LAN parties and things.
What did this cauldron just tell us?
I have no idea. I was reading the chat.
I think I missed it. Can we pop inside of it? Oh, he didn't like that very much.
Nest is asking if sexy Gruntilda's in this one.
She is. You know, I think if you get a game over, you get sexy Gruntilda, if I remember correctly. So she finally becomes like young and beautiful, and then your sister, Banjo's sister, ends up like really old and green and
rental floss Tilda.
Judy's Mac, thanks for joining us. Find a cauldron of the same color and make quick travel. Oh, that's cool.
Oh yeah, that's right. They're like portals.
Really?
They're like portals between areas, I think. If I remember right, I don't know, maybe I'm making that up.
Oh. This looks like a, like, Jude.
You're strong. Good grief. I guess it's just one hit per honeycomb. Raiden says, like in Windwalker, or Weaker. Windwalker. Like in Windwalker. Skinwalker.
Was your not your breath? Is that what he said? You were telling me about something like
There's
that.
There's some funny stuff like that in there. Apparently, Mumbo, one of the things that he says, what is it that he says?
He says something
He says, Omanaka. But apparently, like, the story behind that was that the guy that was doing the voice talent for that ended up with something called a Hydra Seal while they were doing their studio work for the voice acting. Basically what that is like a bunch of fluid that gets like trapped in and causes a testicle to swell.
Oh goodness.
And so the only way to do that, I've actually, when I used to work in surgery, been in one of these surgeries before, but they literally scalpel it open and let like the stuff that's in it out. It's like this pussy stuff. But as he would sit down to do his recording sessions, it quite often would hurt him, and so he would say, oh, my knackers. And they took it and they diced it up a little bit, shortened it, and it became what Mumbo says when he actually casts spells on people.
That's so funny.
Yeah.
Things you'd never know playing this game as a kid.
Yeah, that was from like a YouTube video, an interview of that guy.
That's crazy.
Judy S. Max says, ew. It does sound terrible. The surgery that I happened to I used to do like interpretation from English to Spanish for different surgeons, and in the surgery that I was present in, like the swelling had become like the size of a softball. If you know what a softball is in size, it's
you saw one of the or were you yeah. just interpreting?
I remember the doctor like saying to me like, come up close, watch this.
Oh.
And so like I'm in the OR with him, and I get up close enough that like he's like, here, put on some glasses because it's probably gonna splash you in the face.
That sounds so awful.
And they get out a little basin to hold all of the stuff. But it's kind of a horrible thing. So I can imagine that the poor little voice talent guy was probably in some pretty good pain. You useless pile of dung.
There we are.
Perfect. Raiden says, Banjo Kazooie is filled with so many stories of that kind. The studio that produced this really did have some flavor to it, for sure.
It was, the studio that produced it, Rare, was, it's based in the UK. It's not like a typical Japanese Nintendo developed game.
Right. Raiden's given us hashtag Game Grumps stories. And Judas Max says, no ooh to the skinwalkers. He's used to the medical stuff. Hashtag probably splashed in the face.
Gosh.
Nasty. That was one of the more traumatic things I've ever witnessed at close range. Something is splashing in the face. They have those clear face masks for that nonsense. It's true. We typically only used those when we were doing like surgeries that used laser cauterization.
Oh, really?
Because we had to like, there's like radiation that comes out and you have to like shield your whole face from that kind of stuff. Deep Trout is putting in the subreddit R popping.
Beepo, thanks for following us.
Beepo, beepo.
Glad you joined us.
Thanks for the follow. Have a puzzle piece. Have a jiggy.
Have a jiggy. A jiggy with it. What just opened up?
Hashtag, how's your nuts bark breath? The guest grumps episode was great. I'm not sure what that's referring to. Do you?
I don't know.
Do you get that?
Hey Banjo, you're looking glum. Must be hard being so.
It must be hard being so dumb.
Grunty wears massive bloomers under that repulsive dress. Wow.
She's like a little floating frog fairy.
Hey, we haven't seen these yet. No red feather, I help Kazooie fly. And she knows how. I guess we don't know how yet.
We're just collecting feathers at the moment.
Oh. Here we are.
Chesta says, trending tonight, hashtag how's your nuts bark breath?
Please no.
Ending now. You feel dumb after reading that tweet? She wears giant bloomers.
Just a little bit.
Anonix is saying, remember what she tells you guys, you'll need it. So the giant bloomers comment is going to come in handy at some point. Look at all these puzzle pieces.
All these jiggas.
All these jiggies.
We happen to have enough jiggas?
The bubble goop swamp. We did. Now do we get to like jump through the painting?
That's Super Mario World. Or 64.
Just kidding. Ah, the bubble gloop swamp. Home sweet home.
So if we don't remember what she says, we're gonna rely on you.
You're gonna be our memory, Xenonix. Yeah.
Because there's probably a couple things she's already said that we've missed.
We're easily distracted. Hashtag face guard for nut splash. Oh. Sorry to put that image in your minds.
Part of the history of the game.
It is. It's how it's made right there.
Alright, where was that door that just opened up?
I think that it was
back this way?
Like off in the distance. Let's see.
I think it might be out of current.
Let's get some air before we go up again or through a tunnel.
You should probably get your computer to open those links. That's
yeah,
what
should.
I was talking about.
See, I'm gonna do this the really crappy way and punch it in on my phone because I don't think I'll be able to get that piece of the chat if I open up another computer here. Stop AC says adorable couple must follow. Thank you.
Really nice. Womp womp. Thanks for the follow.
Thank you. I feel like I'm like punching in like a serial number or something here. Typing all of these.
Uppercase, lowercase. Hey, you missed the
capital. Oh, did I
G?
Miss the... Yeah. I missed the capitalization there, didn't I? KJ7. This is really ghetto that I'm having to do it this way. But if I click on it on the computer that the chat's open on, it will probably goof up the video that you're watching. So I'll try not to do that. Okay, I think I got the right one here.
Deep Trout, thanks for giving us a follow.
Deep Trout. You can have a Jiggy as well.
Jigga?
Jiggy is for everyone. It loaded like part of a picture.
This is Kazooie's shock.
I'm confused.
I've had that happen on mobile as well.
I wonder what's up with Imager.
Let's see, I wonder...
I'm gonna copy it and see if I can just, like, save the image. I bet you that will work. Hope it saved it as a partially blank image.
Does anybody know how to get this launcher to go? I didn't read if there was...
You have to, like, spring back somehow. I don't know if... Can we do that yet?
Because it just
there's like
a
spring back. There's, like, a spring back function that you have to do, I think.
Not sure if we have the ability to do that yet.
MJ says, I have a secret. My Xbox and PSN names are secret, or actually, Soapy Sack.
Soapy Sack. Just semi-relevant to the conversation.
Hashtag oh enlarged sack.
Can't wait to get the video for this archived.
I know, this is great.
Yeah, it'll be up on YouTube, don't worry.
It will be. We post everything to YouTube after the fact, so.
We just opened up
I'm talking about
with those jiggas. Those jiggies. I'm gonna call them jiggas from now. We've got a couple places open, we just haven't been to any.
Watching it without context will be kind of funny, you're right.
Yeah, if anybody's watching this later, you had to be there. Ornsome, thanks for following us. Am I saying that right?
Ornsome. I wish I could get that little imager thing to load. I'm gonna, when the broadcast's over, I'll open it up on my, my regular computer. And then I'll take a look. All I can see is, the very top part. I can see that it looks like an egg with, some blue book or something in front of it.
You've activated a magic cauldron.
Maybe it's something I don't want
to
see.
Find two of the same color to create a shortcut. We haven't found the other one.
We found the pink one, did we not? But we... Oh, nope.
Those will probably come in handy later.
Sure. Orange some? Is that what it's supposed to be? He says close enough, haha.
Oh, we're glad to have you here.
We are glad to have you. Look, there's a silver skull. We can finally turn into whatever Mumbo's gonna turn us into.
Well, we've got six of them now.
Do we? Oh, we're over and above.
Oh, wow.
There's an opening in the pipe. And the J is going to make a GIF with subtitles.
Oh, great.
Orange Samba.
O-R-N-G Sumbi?
Orange Samba. Orange Samba.
Yeah, RNG. I'm really not worried about that on the first time playthrough.
What are you saying?
The random number generator. Remember how we were talking about Earthbound?
Yeah. I get what you're saying. O-R-N-G Sumbi. I get it.
Are those places that we've unlocked outside of this whole area that we're...
That one, it seems like we have to go out into the main plaza, where we were for the first level. Have we already been out there, though?
We'll take a look. It just showed it at a distance that we had unlocked it.
Stop Pack or Stop AC says, finally found a stream to watch while working on commissions late at night. What sort of things are you being commissioned to make? Sounds fun. Is it art, music, photos, videos, sculptures? Pink Spaghetti says, orange samba sounds like a delicious drink. Indeed.
Or some like some orange shoes.
Some orange sambas. Adidas makes my very favorite shoe, the samba.
Got some bright red ones.
I'm wearing red ones right now.
I'm wearing the black ones right now. Oh, here's one of the levels.
Treasure Trove Cove.
All right, new level time.
Is this one of the ones that we unlocked?
Yeah, this is the one we unlocked.
Okay, cool. Hopefully we're not playing too far out of order.
I don't know if there's an order to all this.
No, it's just a quest for puzzles.
Wait, this is the Treasure Trove Cove. There'll be two new moves here. We've got to learn the two new moves by talking to them. Wait, what's that guy's name? Bottles?
Goggles.
Goggles? Or
goggles. That's Goggles, I thought. The little mole? Yeah, Goggles.
Snacker smells tasty. Shoot. I guess I shouldn't go into the water.
Stop Back or Stop AC? How do you like your username to be said, Stop Back? It says artwork. Most of my work for other streamers who want their profiles decorated with illustrations and all that jazz.
Oh, cool.
Do you have a creative channel?
We'll have to watch it.
We've tuned into those, and we really like them a lot.
Yeah, I really like watching the creative channels.
Yeah, they're some of my favorites, honestly.
I watch them whenever we're at the gym, too.
Nesta says he enjoys our channel for the trip down memory lane. And Xenonix confirms that this is level 2.
Oh, great.
So we're in the right place. And apparently his name is Bottles. I was wrong. Goggles is not the name of the little mole. Huh. Most people pronounce it Stopak. Got it. Stopak. I'm going to remember that.
Not stop the air conditioner.
Stop the AC! It's too cold. Watch out for the shark.
Where he is, but he's not right here.
We need that. those. Some of those for us.
Running in circles is busy.
Stopak says, do they have a channel here on Twitch? No YouTube yet. We found that it's pretty easy to link to a YouTube account. Twitch kind of takes care of the uploads automatically afterward as soon as you have those links.
You've got to set it up right. So if you just go to your settings and tell it to archive, oh no. Oh no.
Oh no.
Oh no. Let's get out of
here. Swim, 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 swim.
But if you go to your settings and tell it to automatically archive your videos, and then once...
Ah.
Oh, jeez.
That was terrifying. We just got attacked by a shark. Traden says he's working on something for the stream.
Oh, cool.
That's cool. I'm excited to see what you come up with. For those of you that don't know, Traden is quite the musician.
Yeah, he's he linked some of his previous songs. We have it in our Twitter feed as well.
Yeah, if you hop onto Twitter and search for the @Tweedsmith handle, you'll be able to listen to some of Traden's work on SoundCloud, I believe.
Yeah, just link it to us again.
Yeah, if you want to, you can drop the links into the chat here and people can listen. Really some great work. We love it. Stopak says, I'm working on it, Shasta, speaking of the portfolio.
Zane Onyx, thanks so much for the donation.
Whoa.
That's awesome.
This is going to be a fun stream. Can't wait to see what you guys do next. Thank you.
Cool, thanks a lot.
That really means a lot. We have pledged to donate our donations to bettering the Twitch community, making our stream as good as it can be. So thank you. That really, really does help us out, and that's something that we appreciate.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
I was looking through here. Let's see. Topek says, I can always supply a list of people I've worked for. It's a lot of people that I need to update my profile with.
Yeah, we'd like to see some of your work.
Yeah, I would too. We're gonna, when we're done with the stream tonight, we'll look you up and see if we can find at least some of your previous broadcasts. Judius Max, thanks for the follow. Have a jiggy.
Have a jiggy. Shoot.
A jiggy for you. We're gonna die out here.
We're in rough waters.
We're in big trouble. Ooh, ooh, they're fast too.
There's nowhere to go around here.
Ooh. Anytime you fall off, he's gonna get you way down there too. Don't be fooled.
Ooh.
Ooh.
I think we're toast.
Just swim for
land.
I'm
trying.
Oh my gosh.
We went the wrong way.
Oh, we are so dead. Do we have an extra life?
We've got 4 lives.
Thank goodness.
I think we'll be okay, but we're definitely gonna die now. That's rough. Well, it'll give us a nice fresh start on the level. I was just about to learn, I think, that jump attack that we needed to fly.
To be able to fly with the feathers, right? It's on the Twitter.
Rough.
I missed some of the chat. Shasta says he would die laughing. I'm not sure about what. Beadman says, I want to play this again. And the second one. I've never played the second one. I just learned that there was a second one the other day. Gosh, all the enemies here are just killing us.
Maybe when we're done with this game, we could put it up for poll as one of our options for Banjo-Tooie. When we finished Mother 3, this was one of the options for our next games and was chosen.
Thanks for tuning in tonight, Judius Mac. He says we've got an 8 a.m. class tomorrow, so definitely time to get to bed if you've got that ahead of you. Thanks for tuning in.
Thanks for tuning in.
Thanks for the follow.
We're planning on streaming again. I think we put for Sunday night. Does that still work?
Yeah, I think Sunday night's going to be our next stream of this game, so we'll have a couple of busy nights in between, but we'll be back Sunday, so...
Yeah, so we'll look forward to seeing you then. Watch
for us then. Testa says, I can't watch you guys at work. I keep busting up at my desk.
The flying disc, but you have to find my molehill before you use it. But I'm sure that's one of the attacks we would learn.
Shark bait. Ooh, ah.
Please no.
We're fish food, according to Thanks Spaghetti. Jordan says, the thing about the second game is that it's literally just as good as the first one, but because of that, whichever one you've played first, you'll like more.
Oh, really?
This one will probably always be our favorite then, if that's the case. I love this game. Still Midnight.
Thanks for following us.
Thanks for the follow, and have a jiggy. We're just giving out lots of jiggies tonight. Have a jigsaw puzzle. Peace.
There's the molehill.
Thanks Spaghetti is going to the gym at the bright now early hour of 6 a.m.
Wow.
You've got more dedication than I do. I have to go to the gym at night. There's no way I'm getting out of bed to go to the gym.
We're not morning people at all.
No. Gym for us is normally like an 11 o'clock at night activity.
Uh-huh.
During like the middle of the night.
We're even considering going after the stream tonight.
Yep. Still Midnight says, all the jiggies. Too bad I never played Banjo Kazooie. Well, you're in the right place then.
Yeah. We'll experience it for the first time.
We're literally just starting tonight, so you haven't missed much.
Wow. We're flying now.
Dynonix likes both of the games. They're staples of my childhood. And the J has coined hashtag all the jiggies. All the jiggies. Help!
How do I get him off?
With lots of red feathers. Oh.
Oh my goodness. Really flying around.
You have to really be able to maneuver this little show here.
We'll get more.
Ooh,
we'll
go out there and slam things. Down on that X.
Oh yeah?
You'll do your down slam there.
Okay.
Slam, slam, slam. Oh, we missed it just by a little bit. I think you have to do it.
Follow the clues if you're looking for gold.
Okay, marks the spot. Pink Spaghetti says, I need him, Shasta. I work there at the gym.
Oh, right on.
That makes sense why you're there so early then. I don't know, some people just like to work out early in the morning. I have a friend that gets up and goes to the gym at 5 every morning for 2 hours.
Which is why you have to be to work at 6.
Yep. Maybe Banjo and Kazooie are lovers.
Oh yeah?
Says Stopak.
Maybe so.
Oh look, there we go. We've got an arrow now. Shasta says, well, Mr. Buff Spaghetti.
Buff Spaghetti.
The mast apparently is climbable on that ship that we were on.
Oh, it's climbable. That's how we get
That's
up there.
That's how we get up there to save the little... What are they called? Jinjos?
Jinjos?
The Jinjos.
Jinjos.
The Jinjos. Shasta says, thanks, carbs. Hashtag, thanks, carbs.
Story of my life.
Topak says, I'm too self-conscious to work out at the gym. I wouldn't feel comfortable with everyone staring at me. That's a valid concern.
For sure.
Especially if you go somewhere like Gold's Gym, wherever those are still around. They're Vasa now.
Here at least.
Yeah, they're here in our state. There's one gym.
You'll reach new heights with my shock jumps.
Oh, cool. That's the one that we needed on that thing that we were on out before.
They're tired. Don't worry. The turkey does all the work. Simply stand on a shock jump disc, press, and hold A. Your energy is a little low. Well, thank you. Nice going.
There's a gym that we have around here that I think is a little more common, like, nationally, called Planet Fitness, and they have a lunkhead alarm. So if you're, like... If you're flexing your muscles or grunting or doing things
that... I feel
like
you accidentally drop a weight, too.
Or if you drop a weight, they'll, like, sound their alarm and embarrass you. I always thought that
they,
was kind of a funny concept. Yeah, they have, like, a bell on the wall that sounds when people are doing stuff like that.
Oh, my gosh. That sounds awful.
Shasta's... He's coined the hashtag... Hashtag Buff Spaghetti Splash Guard. It just keeps getting worse and worse. I'm the J says, maybe they are lovers. Still a better love story than Twilight. Speaking of Banjo and Kazooie. And thanks, Spaghetti, and in true I work at the gym fashion. As everyone's there to better themselves, no need to feel uncomfortable.
True.
That is true. That is the truth. It can be uncomfortable, though, to go and have to exercise in front of people.
Or exercise period.
Sometimes it's just hard work.
So, I think I should try to get over here to the end. These little green panels are kind of tricky to control.
You have to, they're kind of like spring-loaded, all your feet are, I guess. Everyone does have to start somewhere. I have a good friend that just lost 100 pounds, started running over
really?
The course of, yeah, over the course of like the last 7 or 8 months. Some kind of cool stuff. Made a big difference for him too.
I had a friend in when I was...
Oh, those things are terrible.
They can climb up here.
Yeah, they can. They'll follow you.
I had a friend that lost 105 pounds playing Dance Dance Revolution.
Holy cow. Who was that?
His handle was Cool. Q-O-O-L.
On the high scores, huh?
Yeah. But...
That's cool.
He lost 105 pounds.
Playing DDR.
Yeah, Dance Dance Revolution.
Xenonix says you launch from off the spring pad, and you have to hold the key. Stopak is trying to jog for 30 minutes every morning at 4 a.m. Just hope they're safe here in Chicago. Yeah, that early in the morning, especially in a month or so when it's going to be dark in the morning.
Yeah, no kidding.
Could be a little risky, but it's great that you're getting out and doing that.
What's that crying? You hear that?
It's... What is it that
is
cries?
It...
Ooh, stay out of that.
Is it in here?
No, it was something down... I don't remember. I remember something cries, though.
Synergy 017, thanks for joining us.
It's funny, the gym that I go to has a ramp to access the front door. Everyone makes fun of it and says it's catering to lazy people.
That's great.
MDJ says, I lost 20 pounds by changing my diet, no joke.
That's awesome.
I weigh less now than I did in high school like 15 years ago. That's way cool. It makes a big difference just to like watch what you eat. I've been doing that a little bit lately, and it's...
Over the past week, huh?
Yeah, over like the last week. It is making a difference already, so... I think Spaghetti says, best advice I can give you is to surround yourself with people who support your fitness. Stopak. The most successful people have someone else to go with, and they'll hold them accountable.
Yeah, for sure.
It's true. When you have to like actually give your excuses to another person, it makes it harder to make excuses.
All right, I can't.
For me, anyway.
Oh yeah, no kidding. That's why the two of us we go to the gym together.
Yep. Xenonix says that the crying was Cap'n Blubber. He's crying.
Blubber, huh?
Yeah. Shasta says, I just can't give up that midnight burrito. Midnight snacks are very tempting.
They kill me.
Me too. We've
got to
do
that. The
second
jump button is like not responding on this controller.
That second jump.
These little enemies here.
The little bouncy clams.
Uh-huh.
Ooh, got it. There's another Jinjo down there.
Oh, is there?
On top of one of the trees.
Get down there. Next time I fall.
Go. The lighthouse. I'm gonna grunt all those things. I love that she's set up like, she's like, you have to get through my lair to get your sister back. Like, she's set up like a plan, like, if you can earn her, you can have her.
Yeah,
I kidnapped
like
her, but if you can earn her back.
Uh-huh. Is it just locked?
Oh,
there we are.
There you are, and there's a silver skull.
Oh,
now we're up top. Look, there's a springy step
yeah,
there.
That.
Ooh, and a puzzle piece. Don't go yet. I guess we're probably getting up there, huh? Oh, no. Oh, I thought we were going to fall off the edge.
Good.
Holy cow.
Ooh, sheesh.
Stopak is asking if this is part of the Xbox One collection.
I think it's part of the rare replay.
Like their whole release that they did. It is part of the Xbox One collection.
We're playing it. We're playing the N64 version right now.
And it is emulated. That's correct, Shasta.
That's why the game is in 4x3 mode.
Yep.
So we have these like these kind of blurred out bars on the side. We tried a couple different combinations to see what was going to work best for the stream, and we'd like your opinion as well. So we have it currently set up so it kind of stretches the sides out.
It doesn't stretch them, but it just repeats the sides.
Yeah, it stretches the entire image, it shows off the sides. But we also tried stretching the entire game, but it seemed a little stretched since the game was meant to be 4x3 instead of 16.
Caused Banjo to gain a few pounds.
Yeah. And we also have the option where we could just display like a pattern background.
Yeah, we may give that a try too, we'll see.
So, any feedback you guys have would be super helpful.
And the J, it is available on Xbox One.
Yeah.
You have to obviously repurchase it, but...
But I think it's like only $30 for the entire rig.
Yeah, like the whole collection of games. And we fell down, dang it. Oh, there's the blubberin' whatever.
Hey there, I'm Captain Blubber. One last me treasure when we ship...
He's the one that talks down. In burps.
I can't swim. Can you help an old sea hippo? Sure. Banjo's voice.
Orange Simba had the Taco Bell breakfast this morning. Worst decision ever, lol.
Oh, no.
Hashtag Taco Hell.
Or Toxic Hell.
Or Toxic Hell. They have that like chicken and a biscuit thing that they drizzle honey on. It's part of their little breakfast collection. He wasn't even in the water. Where'd he come from?
Where'd
Oh, I hate the shark. Get up there and save yourself for a second. Let him disappear. Does he disappear?
Oh yeah, he does.
The games for that Xbox collection are in 16:9 widescreen.
Yeah, so it is... They re-kind of created it to display a little bit better on modern TV.
Yeah. Stopak was thinking that it was the whole rare replay thing that we were doing with this. We just ended up trying to figure out a way to fill the space that we normally use with our streams, and that's how we decided to do it tonight. The Xbox now has more N64 games than the Wii U.
That's so sad.
Interesting. That is really kind of sad.
Yeah, super sad. How hard is it to release new virtual console titles?
I know, right?
Makes me crazy.
Must be just way more difficult than we think.
This level's a lot bigger than the first one. The first one was more of a training.
And the Jay says, I wouldn't doubt it. Nintendo is seriously in need of some guidance on the goldmine of games they don't release to the public.
No kidding.
Shasta, you may be right. It could just be that a lot of the library is, for whatever reason, caught up in some sort of legal process that prevents them from releasing them. Who knows?
Yeah, I'm sure the licensing has something to do with it.
It's got to.
Since
we're down to one life again, or one health. Orange Samba says the country crunch wrap. Crunch wrap. That's like a tongue twister for me.
What are you saying there?
The country crunch wrap. That's some sort of potato thing. We called it a hash brown.
Gross.
There were like 50 layers of tortilla. I like their little Cinnabon balls. Not the Cap'n Crunch ones that they did. Those ones have a weird aftertaste. But like the regular cinnamon ones with the cream cheese filling. Those are pretty solid.
These bee things have three different lives.
Yeah, they do. Smash it!
Here we are.
Oh, no, we're in much better shape. Is that one of the treasure chests with teeth?
I think so.
I don't remember. Are we able to get in those and get something out of them, or are they just enemies? They're designed to lure us in.
They look like enemies. Like, I don't know if there's anything inside of them.
I wonder if, like, while they're open, if we can jump in and get something.
I know that there's one over here. Should we try it?
Chesta says, you're catching this, Trey. He said, Cinnaballs. You're adding that to the remix. LOL, balls are back, boys. This is I am the J.
That's the theme of the broadcast tonight.
Yeah, tonight's whole broadcast is brought to you by balls. We're dead again. Oh, don't do that. Just stay on your box for a second. Let's reassess.
I'm trying to get onto it.
Reassessing the situation.
No. Oh.
Swim.
Oh well.
That's what we get, I guess.
How embarrassing.
Lord of the Rings orc voice. Looks like balls are back on the menu, boys. Balls are life. And then we got the rainbow kappa. Opa. Well, that cost us a health, little blue Jinjo.
I'm not sure what else is in this level, because we've learned those two attacks, and I'm sure that there's four... Didn't you say that there was another puzzle piece somewhere? Was that a Jinjo?
There was a Jinjo that was up on the top near the lighthouse on one of the trees. Goodness, there are a lot of feathers, too. Apparently there's a little emoji. I don't know what it's supposed to be. Are they cherries? Something that looks like balls.
Oh, lovely. Great.
Testa says, I think that's how I deal with the shark in real life. Flounder about and then die horribly.
Let's not put that to test.
And the J has given us a link that I'm really scared to visit.
I don't know if we should click on that. We only have 2 lives left?
Yeah, we do. We're down to just 2. When that one of those opens up, try jumping in. See, there's musical notes inside. We don't need those. It's not worth it.
I don't think it's worth it.
Stopak says, it's an emote that's supposed to be balls. Twitch staff said they couldn't do testicles. So me and the partner stream came up with the idea of flesh-colored cherries.
Oh my gosh. I love it.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I guess they probably would frown upon an emoji of testicles.
Yeah. MJ says, LOL, it's safe for work.
There are enough boobs on Twitch. I think a couple testicles won't hurt.
Is this how we got to the... This isn't how we got to the lighthouse, is it?
No, we haven't.
Can we fly up that high? Yeah, we've got to find the treasure.
There was that one weeping guy that was asking us to find his boat. Is it down here? Because it was, like, sunken.
Ah, yeah. We have to... There's like a way to drain the water or something.
Oh, really?
Yeah, if I am remembering correctly again. Yeah, the swimming is really, really hard to do. Dopak apparently can make emotes. Those are a few, I guess, that you've created. Those are really cool.
How do you make...
I love them.
How do you make them? Like, you made them, that's cool.
They were the Steven Universe emotes for... Oh, I thought those were the Steven Universe emotes for half a sec.
Oop.
This game is like Super Mario 64 for furries.
That's a really good description.
I like that. I like that a lot. Ooh. That mine. Hey, there's another life. Oh. Oh, we're gonna be down with the shark. We're not. Oh, but there's a crab. Have to get it while it's down.
He's dead.
He's we're good. May he rest in pieces.
Yeah, everybody kind of explodes into giant pieces.
Yeah. Stepex says you have to be a partnered streamer on Twitch once you get that. Every so amount of subscriptions per month, you get a new tier of custom emotes.
Oh, cool.
You start out with two. Interesting, that's neat.
That's really neat.
And so you can create your own and
super
then utilize them, huh?
That's awesome.
That's really cool. Someday.
Someday, yes.
That's our goal.
We're currently in our like first month of streaming still.
We've played one game so far over the course of the last, what is it, 2 or 3 weeks?
Yeah.
This is like our third or fourth week streaming.
Yep.
But I think it's our fourth week streaming. We've been playing for about a month on Twitch.
Yeah, we played Mother 3 all of August. So this is like September's game.
Yep.
We'll see how long it takes.
Did all of our exes reset?
I think they all reset when we died, yeah.
Ooh. I thought we were going to overshoot it and end up in the ocean. Stopak is rooting for us, heart. Thank you.
Thank you.
Shasta says, not bad for your first month. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. It's
been fun. It's been a fun little project for us.
We have some background with like some design, so that helped us a little bit trying to create how our stream looked.
Well, we're still kind of tweaking things and learning new stuff all the time.
Yeah.
It's been really fun though. We've enjoyed streaming.
Yeah, playing with all you guys is a lot more fun than just playing alone.
Yeah, gaming all by yourself.
Or even just like the two of us playing a game. It's a lot more fun having all the interaction.
Yeah, we love being able to like stream with the chat room. That's been one of my favorite things about playing. Ooh, we almost, I thought we weren't gonna make it. Okay. Boy, you're a lot more confident in slamming down like that. I would get scared about where I am.
Just hope for the best.
Hoping for the best. We already got that little skull when we kept it, right?
I think the skull's...
Yeah, we kept the skull. Those dumb little clams down there. See if you can slam that thing. Oh, look. Nice snack for Yum Yum.
He's like completely eating me.
Don't go by him. Who cares about our feathers? There's the little yellow friend.
The ginger.
The ginger. We cannot afford to have another hit.
I know, I'm trying to avoid him.
Okay, slide with care.
Oh cool, Trayden just sent us a link.
Because here you go for the stream.
Cool, we'll play it at the end of our stream tonight.
We will. Dropbox download.
I wish I could get some more health. I'm a little nervous to kill these clams. Oh no.
Sopak says, yeah, you guys definitely are doing well in your first month. I don't even get as many viewers per stream as you guys do, and I have 700 followers. That's awesome.
Wow.
You've got quite a following.
Well, we appreciate you being here too. We'll have to check out your stream.
Yeah, we're excited. It's fun for us to like meet you guys like in the chat rooms and have you tune in because we've discovered a lot of really cool streams this way.
Yeah. What do you typically stream?
Stopak's doing the creative stuff, right?
Oh yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
I didn't see who it was that was talking.
Yeah, sorry, I didn't read the username for you that time. Stopak says, so 17 at 42 followers is hella good. Thank you. Thanks for tuning in, you guys. Bootsmith says it's a picture, not music.
Who says that?
Trayden, sorry, I'm reading the at Tweedsmith tag on the front. This guy was bad news.
Emperor's Beach, you find nothing with it. Fishing brain.
Cheeky bird,
need feathers clipping. Yeah, just try it. Shellhead.
Let me see if I can get in and get that link to see what these pictures are. I needed to open up my... Normally I have my computer here with me. We've got a few computers in front of us. Normally I have one open so that I can click on links and things, and tonight I didn't end up doing it. I'm gonna see if I can get in and grab that link though and check out what you made.
I wonder what the best way to attack this guy is. Ugh. Kind of pauses after a couple snaps.
Do we have...
That's good.
That's good. Do we have the life to be attacking him?
We've got three.
Okay. Testa says, poke the eyes.
There we are. More times.
Raiden's picking up drawing and has been having a lot of fun with it.
Cool.
Opak says, I'm not much of a streamer. I'm in school, so a lot of my streaming is not on a set schedule. That's all right. We stream a couple of nights a week, but it's just kind of when we can. We're kind of in the same boat as you.
Yeah, I think our key is what we've done is we have found like specific times that we know that our schedule is going to be open.
Yeah.
And that's helped us. And we just put the information right up there at the very top.
Yeah, we look at our schedule like the week up and decide when we're going to be able to do stuff, but. Planning them ahead can be a little hard. We just died a terrible death. By crab. Death by crab. We're down to one life.
Well, if we die, then I guess we continue.
I guess so. I don't know what happens when we die.
We just get really ashamed.
I think Spiggy says, bye, Felicia.
Afraid of what?
Probably us dying. Bye, Felicia. Stopek says, that and you have sex appeal. Bam.
There you go.
Well, thank you.
I don't know how much of that we got, but I appreciate it.
we'll take the compliment. Let's see. I'm trying to get in and get that link, Traden.
We need to scroll up a little bit?
No, I'm trying to sign in on the Twitch app itself and see if I can...
I don't know if you'll be able to go backward.
I don't know either, probably not. Maybe I'll have you repost it in just a second once I'm actually able to get in there and get it.
Also just here.
Yeah, I guess so. Is it going to open up a browser window?
Yeah, I don't want it to like interrupt our game.
It'll probably get in the middle of the screen there.
We'll pull it up a little bit. Be alright.
Scroll down again for me.
Okay, try to kill this... You hurt Nipper. Makes me mad. Nipper is kind of an ugly name.
It really is. I hate it.
There we are. Got him.
Ta-da!
And I just did that on my first try.
Bye, Felicia. Poor people that have the name Felicia probably hear that constantly now. Bye, Felicia. The crab is going to get you. What if you posted it to your Twitter? Could you check it from there? That's actually a good idea, Stopak. That would be... If you wanted to tweet us on Twitter, I could pick it up pretty easy, I think. I'm actually just about signed into the chat, though, too, so... Except for I think it's gonna, like, play loud things here. Let me make sure it doesn't.
He doesn't have a Twitter. Alright, we'll open
that's
it up
okay.
in a little bit.
I am on, so if you want to repost again, I'll try to click on it on my phone right now. Hashtag banjo sex appeal. Hashtag exploding sax appeal.
Oh my god.
You're a nipper, Tweed and Smith, 2015. All right, I'm clicking on your link right now, opening in browser.
Shell's really big.
Here it is. How's your nuts bark breath? I like it. We'll repost that on our Twitter with your permission.
That's awesome.
That's great. I love it.
Oh, you're really talented.
You are. You've got lots of talent with drawing too. That's awesome. Are you using like a tablet to do that, or like I guess like a Wacom tablet or something that way? Really cool. I like that.
Brandon Hill 1993, welcome, and thanks for giving us a follow.
Brandon Hill. Have a jiggy.
Very hopeful that you're here with us.
It says, hello, sirs. Hello to you.
Hello.
Thanks for tuning in. Traden, I'm sorry that you're having buffering issues again. I hope it's not anything with our settings.
Bad. We currently have the delay as high as we can get it, I think.
Yeah, trying to... We streamed for like one night a couple of weeks ago with the low buffer beta setting that Twitch is testing out so that we could have... Oh, Remington Pond just gave us a follow. Thanks, Remington.
Yeah, thanks for following us.
Remington Pond. We were trying to have just like the quickest response time possible so that we could interact a little easier with the chat. But we found that especially our international viewers that were tuning in were having a hard time with the buffering that was going on, so we've reverted back to the default setting, and we're hoping that it's going to stream okay for you. Festa says, also Traden, will you please remix Tweed and Smith's conversation from tonight?
Please no.
I know that may be no small feat, but it would be so funny. It would be really funny. And awful. That terrible story that I shared.
Oh boy.
Traden says, I'm still blank when it comes to drawing. But yeah, I got a $200 Wacom tablet about a week ago.
Oh, right on.
Literally, I have a week of experience when it comes to drawing, aside from any experience I had 8 years ago, last time I drew anything.
You're doing awesome. You're doing really well.
I love the Wacom tablets. They're some of my favorite little peripherals to attach to the computer. I use them for photo editing most of the time. Traden says, I need to know what conversation you mean and where the stream is. You'll know the one.
Yeah, it was when we were in the sewer.
It was a little bit of the history of the game. It had to do with a rather grotesque real life story.
You'll know it when you hear it. Oh no.
And Deep Trout, it's thanks to great people like you and the follows you're giving us. We really appreciate that.
What did he say?
He said you're getting lots of followers tonight.
Appreciate you being here too.
Yeah, thank you. Deep Trout has a Wacom Intuos from 93. It's beige.
Oh my gosh.
Matched all of the computers of the time. I've got the Intuos Pro 5, I think.
Yeah, I think that's
I think it's the one that they're currently selling still. They've come out with a new Cintiq. But they're cool little devices. I have barely scratched the surface of what it can do, but I use it mostly in Photoshop and Lightroom. The medium size is the same one that I have, Traden. I've actually, like, in system preferences, taken the whole surface and, like, squozing it down into, like, an inch by inch, as small as it'll go. I find that I'm able to be a little more accurate that way, and I'm only really using part of my surface. At first it was a little strange, but I noticed that the movements felt a lot more natural when I was using it that way. So you might give it a try, I don't know. I've heard a few people do that. It was actually a suggestion someone gave me, and that's why I went ahead and shrunk it down.
This area over here is too dangerous.
This shark is just horrible, isn't he?
Yeah, there's this area over here trying to get up there. I'm not even sure what the reward is, but it's just too dangerous. This shark that just materializes just drives me crazy.
The Peck says, I hate how they renamed the regular bamboo line Intuos, and the regular Intuos is Intuos Pro.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I remember I had a bamboo for work a long time ago. That was one of the tools that was given to me then, and I hated using it. Like, I just didn't have much drive to learn how to use it. Ugh.
Why did I start swimming?
I don't know. Why did you swim down?
It just happened.
This thing has killed us like 3 times and we're down to 1 life.
We're okay. I think we can go explore.
Oh, not again.
Stop.
Its music is like frightening too.
I know, it keeps freaking me
dun,
out.
Dun 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 dun. Every time you're in the water, don't dive down.
I didn't even push it, it just kind of took my momentum. And then Banjo has this animation as soon as he gets on any platform that just makes him try to get off of this thing.
Chesta says, time to buy a better controller, Tweed. We may have to try the regular N64 controller.
We were originally using a USB controller when we were playing Mother 3.
It's and then for this game.
We switched to this Wii U Pro controller so that we could have the analog control here. So we'd have enough buttons, and so this has as many buttons as the N64 controller.
Right.
But there's this animation as soon as Banjo jumps on a platform that just... Maybe it's because of a slight delay that it's happening.
Mm-hmm.
Kills me.
Traden uses GIMP by mouse. I've not played much with GIMP. I know that it is one that's used a lot for kind of an Illustrator slash Photoshop hybrid. Seems like a cool piece of software.
Yeah, GIMP is open source and it's
just
about as powerful as all the other Pro Tools.
Stepek says, when you're setting the mapping on your drawing tablet, unless it's a Cintiq like mine, you should have force proportions on.
Thanks, Spaghetti, for following us.
I'm jealous that you've got a Cintiq. That's way cool. Thanks, Spaghetti. Have a jiggy.
Have a jiggy.
Have a jiggy, will ya? So Pac, we're gonna be streaming for about another 10 minutes. We normally do 2-hour chunks when we stream, so to answer your question, we're coming close to that time.
That killed me.
Hashtag Banjo Sex Appeal, hashtag Banjo X Snacker Shark. Banjo X.
I leave this level now.
I don't know. We didn't finish it.
Well, we got the 2 items. We didn't get like the.
We didn't get the completeness.
We didn't get the completeness.
I think we have to go back there to do that eventually. I'm not real clear in my memory of it, but it seems like we had to.
Sure, we will. Let's take a look and see what other things there are around here while we're kind of wrapping up for the night. I want to see a little bit more of our map.
We are very low on life. Thank goodness there's some honeycombs. We were very low on life. Can you get in that and, like, get fired out of it?
Oh.
Not from that side. It looks like it hangs too far off the edge.
So if we look over here, it looks like it would shoot us over
there's
there.
A puzzle piece.
Oh, imagine that's how we get... I think we can get over there.
Different way. There's a staircase. Yeah, oh, Shasta's posted a link to his wife's baby announcement. It's
cool.
Really, really good. It was one that he posted to Reddit, and it did pretty well there. Super, super clever.
Let's see who just posted that, but somebody
it was Shasta.
Said that we should finish by going back to the first level.
Okay, to get transformed. Huh? Yeah. Let's do it.
That's a good idea.
Switch blows a hole in the side of the ship, so maybe that cannon's not actually to shoot us, but to blow a hole, huh?
Okay, now to get back to first level, remember where we exactly...
Let's see, where are we right now?
We're in a new area, it looks like.
I think that we haven't been here yet.
Back where we were. Try to get back to the original part of the game.
That was on the front page of Reddit, in fact, the Shasta.
Yeah, it's a really cool animation.
It's way neat.
Shasta is super talented.
Shasta does have a lot of talented. A lot of talented. You have a lot of talented. He has a lot of talent.
Such talented.
Such talented, much wow.
Can they replace with him here? don't remember if we came up through there. Or what?
He says, which, if I'm being honest, was kind of horrible. That's true. Reddit's not always a nice place.
Yeah, the comments were always seem to be...
There's always someone that has to, like, rain on someone else's parade.
Reddit's a good place, too.
Yeah. Reddit's fun. I just have become kind of a silent participant. My upvotes and my downvotes. Stopek says, holy blank, Shasta. That's an amazing animation.
Yeah, he's super talented.
I like how... Is it just our chat that... Is it like a setting that is filtering stuff? It does the stars. Holy blank, Batman.
I think it's a Twitch setting we'll have to take a look at.
It's some Twitch thing. That's alright, I guess, that it keeps the chat.
And Onyx said that they found the stream with Reddit, so it's great.
Oh, really? That's cool. Yeah, because you posted a little bit earlier,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, I posted just before
we
started.
I'm glad that you're here tonight. Thanks to Reddit, right?
Nopec says that's our setting.
Yeah, it's some setting we've got.
We'll have to change it.
Hashtag banjo sex appeal is the hashtag to use, guys. Banjo sex appeal it is. Vesta says it's like 98% good, nice comments, and then like two or three people saying mean things about your wife. And that's what you remember.
Yeah, that's
people
exactly
are
what
ruthless sometimes.
You only remember those things, like all the things that say you're super talented, and
yeah,
you remember the one thing that somebody was rude about.
And that's too bad.
It's too bad.
Oh, we have 10 skulls now. How do we get back to that level, that main level? I feel so lost.
Let me know and dump this bear.
Little backpack, then I'll wear. She wants our backpack. It's part of her new,
Her new moda.
Her new Luke. Xenonix. Did you post it in Gamers?
Yeah, I posted it in Gamers.
Oh, cool. So that's where you're from. I didn't know which one you'd posted it in.
Fellow gamers.
Fellow gamers. Subscribers to the gamers subreddit.
Where can we even go? I feel so lost. We've got to get back to the first level before we can finish.
I feel like We have to go across. Remember when we raised those two little, like, things? The two little vents out of the water?
Yeah.
Or was that? Because that was how
we... I think
it
was through here. I think
that was how we
progress.
Got in here.
Are we making progress? From gamers to gramers, staying gay and growing old together.
I like it. Stofak says, boys who like joysticks. Hashtag banjo's banjo. Is this where we just came from, though? We just came through that tunnel.
I don't know exactly. I feel like
we're going
stuck.
In circles.
Maybe I need to get up there towards the top. Here?
Try climbing that pipe. Can you climb that pipe?
Oh, yeah, that's smart. Yeah, this is exactly where we entered.
Yeah, I remember that guy attacking us. Oh, he just, like, farted out an egg.
I got him.
Dub.
I think through here. We came. Okay, I feel less lost now.
Hashtag less lost.
Well, Banjo is a bear. There are some hot, scruffy bears out there in the gaysphere.
Banjo the bear.
Yep.
Hashtag too bad Kazooie, he's not for you. Alright, so now we've got to go behind you, right?
In here?
No, the other way, I thought. We came from across.
I think we entered this area.
That's the lock to us.
This is locked.
Does it... So go pound that little button that's in the corner. The one that's on the opposite side of where we are now. That one there. think it may put those down and open up the vent behind us. I'm not sure.
That's the one that we used to raise that vent.
Oh, they're already raised. Okay. But it didn't open up the thing behind us. That's what I was wondering, is if it caused some shift in the... I don't know.
The original place that we got in here was here, so I don't know if we're in the right area.
Triton says, we're all turning into furries. Stick with us if you want to be a furry. Triton will make sure that gets trending.
Great.
Have to have 180 to get in there.
Oh, goodness.
Go back to where we were before. Go back through that little pipe.
I think we need to go through here.
Okay. I can't believe how turned around we got. That's nuts.
It's obviously a first playthrough or a blind playthrough. Yeah, okay. I feel a lot better now.
Speaking of bears, there's an awfully named show on Cartoon Network called We Bear Bears.
Let's check it out.
Uh-huh. Sharded an egg. Impressive.
Very feathered freak. Nothing but a stupid geek.
That ugly bear, you feathered freak. I like that she talks in rhyme all the time.
All the time.
Okay, now we're back out the mouth. So go back in straight.
Whew. Back in there?
Yeah, we started our first level in there.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Okay. And then I think it was...
Out before furry.
Rear to the right.
In before mega furry. In before Shasta. There you go, that's where we're after. Anybody want a peanut? Stop that, I mean it.
I feel like Kazooie can run a lot faster than Banjo.
Mm-hmm, with her tiny little legs. Or his tiny little legs.
I feel like Kazooie is a girl, but she or he could be a boy.
I don't know. Okay. We're going up and over the mountain.
We gotta get to
Mumba's.
The shaman. Shaman. Remember where he was.
We're getting close to him. He's over there, yep. Watch out for the termites. Xenonix confirms that Kazooie is in fact a girl.
Well, they can still be a couple.
Hashtag Banjo sex appeal. Shake the bear butt. Shake the bear butt.
Must be deceived.
Here he goes. He's gonna like change us. Umanaka.
Oh,
that's the
right
that's
now.
The thing. That's the
Umanaka. Umanakas.
Umanakas.
Come back when you're ready to change.
Yep. Look at our cute little backpack, our little termite backpack. More solid info on that in the second game.
More what?
Solid info on Kazooie being a girl.
Okay, gotcha.
Riden says, yeah, I always thought Kazooie was a boy. It's weird for me that Kazooie isn't. I shan't accept it. Go into the mound now.
Now it is.
It's down the other way.
Over here.
Yeah.
Oh, weird that we're a termite now.
Well, now we can climb on the edges of things too. So we'll be able to do. We'll be able to get up to the top.
Okay. Let's see, in here.
Look, they don't care anymore.
Where did you get those shorts?
I want them.
Some short yellow shorts.
Can you jump still? Whee! MJ says, as a child, I never really gave a gender to Kazooie. It didn't matter, so thinking Kazooie is either a boy or a girl is just weird. Yeah, I could see that, for sure. Oof.
Where'd you hurt me? We're the same kind.
And still get hurt. Okay, slow down and... Oh, you got it. Good job. Where's your next one? Okay.
Camera is like
tricky without the camera cooperating. Okay. Oh, you fell off the edge.
Where were we supposed to?
Hashtag didn't choose the termite life.
We didn't choose the termite.
The termite life chose you.
The termite chose us.
Oh. Oh. Don't touch him.
No, he hurts me. This is no good.
You gotta jump right by the edge. This is so frustrating. I remember this being really ridiculous when I was a kid, too.
Well,
and being really pleased with myself when I finally got all the way up there.
I think that we'll still have that same feeling. If we ever get up there.
If we don't just walk straight down off of it again.
There's a tiny bit of a delay in this Bluetooth controller. We need to get a USB controller with analog stick.
Yeah, we do.
I had one. I lent it to one of my friends. I can't remember who it was.
Probably me.
But just?
No, I think it was me.
Do you have it?
Yeah. I remember I was playing Earthbound with it. He gave it back.
I wonder where it is.
I don't know. I carried it around in my bag for a long time.
Is it still in your bag?
No. Into my bag out. I love the termite jump. Apparently, Think Spaghetti just came back and suddenly we're a termite.
Give me that cool backpack.
Wants our backpack.
Oh, you can't have it.
That never hit me as a motherly thing in the second game. That always struck me as something birds could just do.
What?
I'm not sure. I must have missed some of the... Oh, hatching eggs. Kazooie is called several times as well. She herself talks about hatching eggs in the second game. That makes sense. I see what you're saying now.
Could be a transginger.
Transginger. See what you mean. It wasn't me. We've got hashtag Tweedsmith, hashtag couple skulls.
Okay, we're almost to the top of this thing.
Are we going to be able to reach the little puzzle piece when we get up there? That's the question. Are we tall enough? Oh. Thank goodness that you don't fall all the way down to the bottom.
I would throw a controller over.
This reminds me of Ocarina of Time.
This does?
Yeah, when you're in the Great Deku Tree.
Kind of like that, yeah.
It reminds me of that. Ben's ginger? What was Kazooie before? Brunette? Oh, there's a life. Don't fall off the edge.
I almost did.
I know. I saw.
It's like tempting.
Very carefully, we shall walk. Puzzle piece. Womp womp. What is that?
I don't know what that sounded like.
Apparently we just made some sort of achievement. The whole world just sang us a song. Well, let's stay up top there.
Well, we're down now.
Dang it.
Was there anything else up there?
No, it was just a mighty place to finish our game tonight.
Let's finish the game right over here. Oh, we've got to go back to the shaman in order to
change back.
I wonder what happens if we like leave the world.
Do we stay a termite? We do.
We do. Oh my goodness. Oh, that way we can get up here and get this guy.
Oh my goodness, you're so smart.
Right.
Now we can all breathe easy. Breathes heavily.
Yes.
Yes, a sigh of relief indeed.
Well, thanks guys for joining us tonight. We
it's
really
been super
appreciate
fun.
Your input in the chat and with your participation. It's kind of obvious that this is a first playthrough for us. I think that we repeated several things several times.
We're feeling our way around. Thanks
for
being patient.
We appreciate you guys being patient with us. Yeah, for sure. Definitely takes some getting used to with the controls. We are planning on streaming again on Sunday night at 8 o'clock. If you haven't followed us yet, give us a little follow, and that way you can receive notifications when we do stream live. Also, if you head over to Twitter, you can receive updates on the stream.
Twitter.com/tweedsmith. Ringaro, thanks for the follow.
Hey, thanks for following us.
You can have a jiggy too. One of the last of the night.
One of the last jiggies of the night.
Last jiggy of the night.
So, We were looking through at finishing the game with you guys. We are going to be back on Sunday, and
we've got a long ways to go before we finish.
Yeah, we're not close to finishing yet, but
we're just getting started, right?
But we're glad to have your participation in the chat, and we'll see you guys on Sunday night.
All right, good night.
Thanks for joining us.